Alright, I'm here with the Cricut Design Space to show you how to make that cute Valentine card. The file is free. You can download it from my blog, ideacloset.blogspot.com. I just finished doing a silhouette tutorial, and so now we'll try one in the Cricut. Of course, to start with the Cricut, you have to be connected to the internet, and you have to be at Cricut Design Space. You cannot do this without the internet. I'm going to come over here to where it says File, and click File, and New. And I apologize, my computer, for whatever reason, is running really slow. Now we're going to upload our images, and we're going to come to Upload Image. We're going to get a window that has a Browse on it, and we're going to go ahead and browse, and find where we saved that image. Now, I would suggest that if you find that you start downloading a lot of SVG files from the internet, that you either do them to a flash drive or you set up a folder on your desktop or something like that so that you know where they always are. If you can't find them, check your download file first. Mine are under here. And this is our heart cutout card. I'm going to click on it and go ahead and open. And it will bring everything in that you need for that file. Up here, it has the same name that I had already given it. You can change that if you want to, or leave it as is. You can also tag it. So I'm going to put Valentine's. Whoops, if I can spell. Valentine's. I'm also going to put hearts and cards. By putting a comma in between all those, I've just added those three tags to that. Go ahead and hit Save. And there are my images. Now I can just go ahead and select on it and hit Insert Image. And it will pop up right here on my screen. There is everything that we need for this card. And you can come down here and shrink that just a little bit so that you can see it. Now I made this to fit on a 12 by 12 cutting mat. And I found that it's just a hair too big to do it on a Cricut mat. I don't know why, but it is. So while it is still all grouped together, open up your edit window. We're going to come over here to the height, and we're going to change this to 11.25. We're going to keep the aspect locked, hit enter, and it's going to shrink it down just a hair so that it can fit on the Cricut mat. While it's still group, go ahead and hit your layers button again. And then we're going to come down here and ungroup everything. And now all of your images are each individual images. Decide if there are any of these pieces that you do not want. The three hearts right here, Be Mine, You Are Cute, and Call Me, are made to be a print and cut image. And so I'll show you how to do that. This is just a blank card if you want it for the front or the envelope or the inside or to write your own little saying on it. I'm not going to use it. I'm going to click on it and then just delete it. This piece right here is either for the inside so that you can write on it, or you could cut it out with some acetate and then use it to make like a shaker card or something if that's what you chose. We're not going to use that either. I'm going to delete it. Next, we want to get these three hearts ready to do print and cut. You have to do them one at a time. I'm going to just select everything. Whoops. Then once it's selected, I'm going to come over here. Oops, didn't do it. I'm going to select everything. And then we're going to flat. We're going to do that with each one of these. And you'll notice when you do that, that red line around it disappears. That's just because it's making it now a print and cut image. Do it one more time. Okay. The last thing that we're going to do to get this set up is we're going to move this piece, and we're going to move these two pieces over here. They really don't matter. You can still cut them while they're showing on there. They don't have to be moved. But the reason I did is we need to grab this card and the perforation, and then we need to attach them so that the perforation marks will cut out the card. Otherwise, it doesn't do it. That's just one of the ways that the Cricut works. Once this is set up and looks like this, you can go ahead and sync it. What sync does is it just shows you that everything is on its own layer. I want these two pieces cut out of the same paper, so I'm going to move that up there. And we're ready to go. Now we're going to hit go. My Cricut is not plugged in and turned on, so I'm probably going to get a sign that says I can't do this, but we'll go as far as we can. Once this is ready to go, you'll get over here and your first mat will say print and cut. And you can go ahead and print it and then cut it, and then you'll cut it just like you do all the time with your other images. You'll go to each mat and cut each piece. I hope this is helpful for you. I hope you enjoy this file. If you do make this card, let me see it. Oh, here we go. So here's your print and cut. So you'll print this one, and then you'll cut it, and then you'll go to each mat and cut out each piece. Anyway, as I was saying, I hope that you'll make this card and send me a picture, post it on my blog, or send it to me via email, and I'll post it and or put it in Pinterest. But let's see what you can do with this card. Thanks for watching.